spirit. All right. Sixth graders, would you give us a bow? Position and a bow. Before I say goodbye to these lovely young people, and we are missing a few, they've been away at camp, so just having them here tonight, I know it was stretching it, but I'm so pleased with the students that have made it here tonight. They also know the names of their strings. They know every single part of these instruments. They know how to take care of them. They know how to put them in their cases and walk with them. They know where not to put them around the school and how not to keep them in a hot car in the summer or a frozen car in the winter. They know a lot of things, so I'm looking forward to working with them. You will see them again at winter, and you will hear them play gloriously. Thank you, and give them a hand. Short concert, maybe an hour or less. I'm giving about a 10-minute demonstration on some music software. I would really like to encourage, if possible, sixth grade, seventh grade, eighth grade, ninth grade, and anybody who is interested in having all these accompaniments to your disposal as you practice. There's a lot of other bells and whistles that go along with this software. There's a little expense involved with it, and that's why I'm presenting it to you tonight. There's a handout with it, and we're going to demonstrate it with some students, so I hope you'll enjoy that portion of the program. But it's meant to be short, and we want the sixth graders and every student here to hear everybody play. Is it on?
Yeah.
Yes. These students meet 2 days a week, so everybody else in the whole building meets 4 days a week. We had instruments to distribute and names to learn and music to distribute and meet tests to take. So we are still right at the edge of finishing our review from the previous year, the wonderful work that Mrs. Wonder has done with the students. And so we started with our review and ended with something, a couple of things that were new. I hope you'll enjoy it. Piece where you will see the differences between the first violins, the second violins, and the cellos and the violas and the bass. They all have their own unique part coming together to make some beautiful harmony. New World Symphony. This can help find their families. That would be lovely. I see everybody's pretty much done that. If they couldn't find you, they can still sit right where they were. We get to do seventh grade B Day. And I'd like you to give a warm welcome to the B class that meets on the other 2 days of the week.
Thank you.
Thank you.
there is a solo called Where the Trees No Longer Grow, and that is what Gabby has chosen to play for her solo tonight. Please enjoy. Our next selection is called Stanwell Perpetual, which is taken from a string quartet book written for piano, a piano string quartet. And it was written by Catherine McMichael. She's still alive. She lives in Saginaw. Her husband is a violinist, so she has a wonderful combination of piano and strings in her life and in her family. This set of quartets is written for different roses, and I don't know what the Stanwell Perpetual looks like, but before we're finished this week, we're going to Google it and find out what that rose looks like. So on piano is featured Violet Butts and the High School String Orchestra for Stanwell Perpetual. Thank you. DiCaprio. That is by a very strange composer by the name of Peter Warlock, and that's the name that he chose after he was born another name. So that's our tribute to Halloween this next week. So our final piece is called Wired, and that's exactly what it is.